So first, let's find the average of all these values. You can see that the values go all the way to 101. Since there's not a value in cell A1, there are 100 values. So here, we'll write equals average A2 through A101. That gives us the average. Now here, we type A2 minus whatever we got for the average, which is our deviation. So equals A2 minus 50,586.36. I usually like to round it to two decimal places. Make sure that you don't put in any commas. Now, we drag this down all the way to cell B101. And now we have each deviation from the mean. So remember, this is xi minus x bar. Now we're going to square each deviation. Equals B2 squared. And again, we're going to drag this all the way down. Now we can find the average of the squared deviations, which is the variance. So we write equals average C2 colon C101. So now we have the variance. And finally, we take the square root of the variance to find the standard deviation. Equals SQRT of cell F1. And you always know if you're using the right cell if there's a dotted line highlighting it. So here it is. You should have gotten approximately 10,657 for your standard deviation. Due to rounding, there is a range for answers that were correct in this quiz. Good job! This is really tough stuff. And actually, this is probably one of the most complicated calculations that you'll have to do throughout the rest of this course.